Hey guys, what's up? Seems that a lot of people like the image I post 2 or 3 weeks ago on Facebook, and then I decide to make a quick open scene about this scene and explain a little bit how I made it. Okay, so this scene is also in Blender Market, so if you want to explore a little bit more, you can access the link down below and have more information on Blender Market. Okay, so let's get started. So the first thing I think everybody was curious was about the glass. So the glass, I got it from Polygon. Maybe I think it was this one, Raindrop and Strix 001. Okay, but in fact, I'm not putting these textures in this file. Actually, I had to create another droplet because this one I can resell. Okay, so I created a new one using Substance Painter. Okay, so I'll show you. Just a second, let me see where I put it. Substance here. 1 second. It is on my other screen. Okay, here you go. So this is the guy I just imported the glass from Blender to Substance Painter, and I apply a mass, I think a matte FX water drops. So this effect created this droplet on any surface. So I use this guy and I exported the texture from Substance Painter and I place it on Blender. And the next thing that we are going to discuss is about the HDRI. The HDRI, I got it from Heaven, HDRI Heaven. Heaven HDRI, let me see. HDRI Heaven.com. So if you go to Overcast, then you can get it from there. The name is Rural Graffiti Tower. Okay, so you can even have it in higher resolution, 19K. So it's amazing. You can get it from there as well. It's really a good one, really good HDRI. So let me open the HDRI over here and I show you in the kernel. Okay, here. So as you can see, I didn't increase the power, even the gamma, even the texture power. So it's all default right now. So, and even like the 3D transform, I didn't rotate any parameter. Okay. Okay. The other light setup, the other light I'm using here is this plane light. So this plane light is a fill light. Okay, because I have the key light coming from the HDRI, and the back of my image was completely dark, as you can see. So I had to include this lighting plane to fill it up a little bit. And this is something that's very important when we are talking about lighting setup. We always have to have fill light. We have to have a key light, but still we have to have a fill light, otherwise it will be very dramatic. Okay, so the other thing is I think I'm not using any depth of field. Let me see, but you can use it to bring more realism to your scene, but I'm not using it here, and probably I tested it before, but for some reason I didn't choose to move forward. The other thing is my Octane camera imager. The response type, I'm using this AG FA color, and also I'm using an LUT. Okay, so the LUT I'm using in this scene, I also providing it on Blender Market as well. Okay. And probably I will record a video to explain how to do that as well. Okay, the exposure is very low. I'm not using any other thing here. So Octane post processing, I'm using bloom power to bring some bloom to the candles and this overcast feeling as well. Okay, so the camera setting, let me see, the render setting, I'm using path trace. Max samples, I use 2,500 for this scene. Okay, but I think it's still too much. I could use less than that. So you can try it. Max depth, max diffuse, max glossy, and max scatter, you can put it in 8. I was just trying another setup, but 8 is more than enough. We don't have like too much lighting going on here. It's just direct light. So GI as well, we can keep it in 1 and more than enough for this scene. Another thing that's very important, I'm using adaptive sampling. So adaptive sampling, it's always good to turn it on, okay? Octane out of core, you can turn it off. And okay, let me show you a little bit about the architecture of this scene. It's pretty simple. Actually, I use this scene in another post I did last week, I think. It's about a living room, more a Scandinavian living room. So I use the same setup, the same architecture. Okay, so very simple. Thank you guys. Thank you a lot. Thanks a lot. And I hope you like it. And if you have any questions regarding this scene or anything else, just let me know. Make your comments down below, and I will be glad to answer. Okay. Thanks again, and thanks for watching.